Good morning, citizens of Planet Roller Derby. I am Lightning Slim. I'm joined here by my good friend Pink Slaminade. You're watching the 2016 International WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Montréal, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Montreal Roller Derby. So today, we'll be watching Sun State take on Detroit. Sun State from Browns Plains in Australia. Coming into the tournament, the number 8 seed, ranked 29th in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Detroit from Detroit, Michigan, of course. 9th seed, ranked 35 in the WFTDA. Pink, do you have some rosters?
Taking a look at these rosters from Sun State, Roller Girl Swarm, number 00, Coconuts, number 117, Chop Chop, number 180, SX, number 182, Sticks and Bones, number 187, Veruca Salt, number 24, Trauma Junkie, number 32, Jambi, number 58, Dodge and Bolt, number 65, Janosaurus Rex, number 7, Baby Rocket, number 89, Slayer Swift, and number 90, Edwards. Coming at you straight from Motor City in Detroit, we have 08, Jillian Rooker. We have number 10, Swift Justice. Number 13, Off the Hook. Number 241, Lolly Pops 'em Hard. Number 247, Boo Delivers. Number 28, Racer McChaser. Number 33, Cookie Rumbles. Number 38, Tigga Hitties. Number 4, Meryl Slaughterberg. Number 40, Kelly Janai. Number 428, Freakin' Reekin. Number 45, Feta Sleaze. Number 620, Laser Beam. Number 66, Perish Her. And that's our rosters for your game two right here from Saint-Pierre Charbonneau.
Officials for the game led by crew head referee Lauren Order. We also have Jules and Regulations, Davey Darko, Code Adam, Samiracle, Divine Intervention, High Refinition, and alternate referee Judge Double Wapner.
Of course, joining us out on our announcer table, we've got Eight-Wheeled Freedom, written by your very own Derby Nerd. Did you know that Dave Miller, he wrote a book? Check out Eight-Wheeled Freedom.
So what are we looking forward to here, P-Slam?
I mean, looking at these teams, you have your 8th and 9th seed. Sun State making their first appearance at WFTDA playoffs last year. This is their second time at a WFTDA playoff. Detroit, sort of perennial favorite here. Detroit having a rough season. Right now they're ranked at number 35. But in the last month or so, taking on some very serious teams with a win over Tampa, 245 to 186. Tampa currently ranked 15th in the WFTDA. So looks like a pretty big build year. We also have Jillian Rooker, who is an Olympic speed skater, long track speed skating in the Sochi Winter Olympics.
So maybe some interesting pyrotechnics on the track from that particular skater. And you think with the numbers you just put out, that Detroit might be a little underranked.
Absolutely. So it's both teams a bit of a question mark coming into this game.
Coming up to the fast girl start line for the Swarm of Sun State, Jambi, and the aforementioned Jillian Rookert for Detroit. But it is Jambi out first wearing the black. It is Detroit wearing red, of course. Jambi now approaching a pack. It's in turn number one. Jambi trying to move around the outside, and one of her own skaters calls it off quickly before Rooker can arrive, and that is a single point pickup, first blood to Sun State.
Jambi with a 59% lead jammer percentage over the 2016 season for Sun State.
Resetting here on the track, Detroit putting out Feta Sleaze, number 45, and it will be Baby Rocket, number 7 in the black for the Swarm. The pack pushing back as a mass against the jammers. But Baby Rocket coming around the outside. She has lead. Feta Sleaze giving chase. But Baby Rocket for Sun State hits and quits immediately. And another single point pickup for Sun State. That will make it 2-0 after a couple of jams down.
Yeah, really smart entry with the hips there. Just one and done.
Coming into the third jam, 28 and a half minutes remaining. Rookert returning to the jammer line, the fast girl start line for the Detroit Derby girls, and it is Chop Chop, number 117, jamming for Sun State. Notice Swift Justice jamming for Detroit. They made a correction there. And Swift Justice, just one to beat at the front of the pack. Swift Justice, lead jammer for Detroit. Swift Justice struck down in the pack, decides to call it off before Chop Chop can arrive. And that will mean points on the board for Detroit. How many? It is four.
Lead change in favor of Detroit. Did you know that in addition to helmets, S1 now makes pads for Roller Derby 2? Make S1 part of your uniform. S1helmets.com.
Trauma Junkie taken to the Fast Girl start line for the Swarm. Racer McChaser, veteran skater for Detroit, taking the star for them. Racer McChaser puts her opponent out and makes a play to the front of the pack, and Racer McChaser is lead.
It's 2-2 for lead jammer status for Detroit, and a track cut penalty to Sun State's jammer.
The Trauma Junkie taking a seat in the penalty area. That will mean Racer McChaser with a power jam. She already has 5 points on the board in the jam. She won't be satisfied with that as she comes around the single blocker left.
Sunset with a full penalty box. Adding and subtracting blockers in and out here. Not what they want on a power kill.
Oh, a nice movement from the inside to the outside by Racer McChaser to put up another 5 points. That was a huge jam to open things up a little for Detroit. 15 points on the board. That will bring them to 19-2 over Sun State.
Racer McChaser, one of a very deep jammer rotation for Detroit. You're seeing a lot of Jillian Rookard this year and of Sarah Heipel, but Racer McChaser, Swift Justice, Feta Slee, they've got a deep well of talent for jammers on this team.
Going back to Jillian Rookard, in this case, number 8 for Detroit. She has the power start, but unable to get out of the pack. There's a braced 3 in front of her. Trauma Junkie has returned to the track for Sun State. Trauma Junkie moving to the front, gains lead, but Rookard is directly behind her.
A little jammer on jammer play here from Jillian Rookard. All smiles there, but.
Yeah, that will force the call off with no change to the score.
Rydell Skates, the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years. Visit them at rydellskates.com. On your Fast Girl Skate start line, we've got Feta Slees for Detroit, and she's facing up against number 3-2 Jambi from Sun State. Jambi making a big name for herself at last year's WFTDA playoffs in Dallas.
Jambi now in the center of the pack, finds a ton of space on the outside of turn number 1. One blocker to beat upends her. Jambi with lead. Jambi now on a scoring pass. Moves, oh, and striking down a blocker. Has she received a penalty? Yes. Blocking to the back. Jambi of Sun State will sit power jam Detroit.
Sun State thought it was over, but Feta Slee's taking advantage of that with that huge jump.
Currently a 5-0 jam in favor of Detroit. Feta Slee skates on. That is another 5 points. The pack still now in between turns 2 and 3 on the back straightaway. Feta Slees inside the pack. The pack swirling around.
Detroit not really being able to coordinate that offense there. A bit of a clump on turn 3, but Feta Slees makes it out with 5 points.
Once again, double point jam for Detroit. They've opened up a lead here on Sun State after they scored Sun State scored the first 2 points, but it's been all Detroit since. Jambi is back from the penalty area, but drawn back, unable to gain access to the pack. Feta Slees also recycled. Just about 12 seconds remaining in the jam.
Sun State really locking down on their defense here. Detroit is trying to offer some sort of defense offense as they wrap around the black skaters on the inside of turn 4.
Swarm pushing out Feta Slees one last time before the jam is called. 23 minutes remaining in the first period of play. Sun State 6, Detroit a score of 37.
Detroit really pulling away now from Sun State and really showing that experience that comes from not only a bunch of experienced skaters, but really a tough training regimen, a tough game schedule coming into this tournament.
Baby Rocket and Racer McChaser, jammers of the right now. Racer McChaser, physical as always, tries to force a way around the outside, then moves to the inside, shrugging off hits from Sun State blockers. Racer McChaser with a recovery heads to the outside, but meanwhile, Baby Rocket stealthing away through the center of the pack gains lead.
Racer McChaser recycles way to the back of turn one.
Now Baby Rocket on a scoring pass tries to go the outside route, is put into the center of a triangle. She takes some physical punishment but emerges with the full five.
Sun State seems to really lock down their defense at this point, but they're able to get separated by Detroit.
Yeah, Racer McChaser now free, eligible to score. That means Baby Rocket will call it off before McChaser can arrive. That was an additional few points on the board for Sun State. Just under 22 minutes remaining in the first period. Detroit 38, Sun State a score of 15.
Of course, support for this stream is brought to you by Radar Wheels. Check out the new Radar Halo wheel.
5-second warning, Chop Chop and Jillian Rookard, your jammers. Away they go. Rookard tries the outside line, finds the way blocked. And Chop Chop gaining not lead, but a penalty. Very different kind of whistle.
That's not the one you want.
And so, power jam for number 08, Jillian Rookard.
Sun State with three back block penalties so far in this game, and we are only on jam 8. Those are all from jammers. So coming in a little bit too hot here from Brisbane, Australia. Jillian Rookard recycled way to the back as we approach turn three, having a very hard time on the lines against Sun State.
And now, Chop Chop returning from the penalty area. That was a great penalty kill by Sun State.
Absolutely.
Chop Chop, oh, struck down there. Number 40 doing work. That's Kelly Janai knocking down Chop Chop, but Chop Chop able to complete that initial pass. Rookard tries an apex jump but is bumped to the interior, calls it off. Did Chop Chop gain any points? No.
That was just in time on that call off. A bit of a visual barrier there on the inside, but 10 points picked up by Jillian Rookard in that pass. Your score 48-15.
2016 International WFTDA Championship tickets are on sale now. You can be a champion VIP. Get your VIP tickets to champs for only $125. They include the best seats in the house, a collector's program, and a VIP badge and lanyard.
Of course, Sun State calling a timeout now, which is brought to you by rollergirl.ca. It's Canada's skate shop experience, Canadian customer service.
So yeah, Sun State, maybe a handy timeout at this juncture, P-Slam. Like, they had the first couple of jams. They're able to gain lead, but that is not reflected on the scoreboard.
Absolutely not. And it seemed like it took their defense a little bit of time to wake up. Now you see their formations a lot tighter, a lot slower. There's a lot more trust being shown. But again, the jammer penalties being a really big liability here with those back block penalties.
Yeah, specifically that back block, which seems to have become an issue, and it's not always the same jammer. It seems to be across the board.
Detroit seems to also be able to get spread out with their defense, but their offense, that blocker-on-blocker aggression, is really powerful coming from Detroit. So I don't think Sun State necessarily prepared for that yet.
Clock frozen at 19:50. Detroit 48, Sun State at 15. And that timeout coming to a close for Sun State. We'll get back on track here. It will be Trauma Junkie for Sun State and Swift Justice, number 10 for Detroit. Swift Justice making a quick play up the inside line. She has lead for Detroit. trauma junkie at the receiving end of some trauma from the blockers of Detroit.
Really smart re-entry by trauma junkie, not buying that blocker fake out from the player who was behind her, allowing her to sort of get through that weakened pack.
4-point pass by Swift Justice. The pack is in turn number two. And oh, a slide on the track as Trauma Junkie upends the pivot of Detroit, avoiding the low blocking penalty.
That took a year off my life. That was one of the scariest things I've ever seen.
It was a bit of a slew foot situation in which that pivot went flipping over the body of that jammer. However, no injuries. Everyone kept skating.
A bit of a limbo contest in the back of that pack from Trauma Junkie. Your score, 55-19, just under 19 minutes left in this first half. Sun State beginning their comeback against Detroit, but with Feta Slees on the line now against Jambi on your fast girl skate start line.
And Jambi with a burst of speed. Jambi quickly gaining lead and has half a track on Feta Slees as Feta Slees exits the pack. The pack drifts backwards into the start box. And Jambi sees Feta Slees go rocketing by. Doesn't want to call it off until she's caught up some of those points. Now calling it after four aside.
Yeah, that hesitation meant that no one came out ahead in that jam. Not sure if she underestimated Feta Slees' speed or just that visual distraction of being caught on lane four.
If you're listening to the free audio coverage this weekend, it is not too late to get the high-quality video feed. It's just $15.99 for the weekend, or it is still a good deal at $75 to get all of these Division I's and championships.
Racer McChaser on your Fast Girl Skate start line going up against number one from Sun State. Number seven, Baby Rocket, your lead jammer.
Yeah, Baby Rocket with a great burst of speed now caught in the center of a triangle being broken up there. An assist from Edwards, her blocker.
A big pileup in the back of this pack.
That was the aforementioned Edwards getting mixed up with Freakin' Rican. Racer McChaser skating in the free and open spaces, but Baby Rocket has a grand slam, decides that will do, calls it off.
WFTDA would like to mention 888 at 888.com, protecting Derby since day one.
And so with that 5 points, Sun State will bring themselves up to a score of 28 points. Detroit at 59. And just about 16 and a half minutes remaining in the first period.
Detroit choosing to use a three wall in the back with sort of a roving blocker in the front.
And that's Joe Rookard and Chop Chop jamming. No lead jammer yet declared. Both of them applying themselves to the pack, and it is Chop Chop with great speed, picking up lead. Rookard with a little leap over the apex to get herself chasing Chop Chop, the pack between turns one and two. A leap there from Chop Chop, and she did stick the landing just enough to call it off. Applause here from the Sun State bench as Chop Chop heads back with 4 points.
Yeah, this is Sun State's third lead jammer status in a row now, and you can see it reflected in the score as they start to creep up on Detroit. But Detroit, a little bit more consistent. It'll remain to see how we go into halftime here.
That is Feta Slees returning to the Fast Girl start line against Trauma Junkie.
Trauma Junkie playing some defense, trying to free one of her two blockers from the box.
Yeah, she does get one back, but at the cost of giving up lead to Feta Slees. Feta Slees now three in the back for Detroit. Now they move up and engage with the blockers of Sun State, and a collision in the apex. Trauma Junkie manages to right herself. A little chaos inside the pack as Trauma Junkie skates on.
Another missed call-off here. Feta Slees this time not noticing the approaching jammer. Matching her point for point now.
Yeah, as Feta Slees with a glance back at her bench realizes, oh yes, calling. Yes, calling it now.
Yes, I have that power.
And so a reversed score, 36-63 in favor of Detroit over Sun State.
The WFTDA would like to thank our hosts, Montreal Roller Derby, as well as 5-on-5 Magazine and Derby Central.
Montreal, fabulous hosts. We are in the Olympic Village section of Montreal from the 1976 Games. This venue used for wrestling, I'm given to understand.
Well, we're not that different from it here. A very physical game so far. Racer McChaser, lead jammer.
Jambi giving
Detroit.
Chase, yes. Racer McChaser now on a scoring pass, but Jambi overtaking and gaining points. And that's two jams in a row in which the Sun State jammers have managed to overtake their opponent.
Yeah, I don't know if it's the placement of the Detroit bench being, I mean, both of, almost all three of these late calls had happened around turn one, turn two, and Detroit sitting at turn four, but maybe jammers used to listening for their bench and losing track of their opponent.
It is true that those missed call-offs have been happening in turn two, which is as far away as you can get from that bench.
Absolutely.
Baby Rocket returning to the Fast Girls start line, as does Swift Justice.
Forearm penalty going to the pivot from Detroit, number 3-3.
That's Cookie Rumble. And Baby Rocket with lead. Lots of room to skate as Swift Justice is being held back and recycled by the pivot of Sun State. Baby Rocket collides just outside of turn number two, now in the straightaway.
Swift Justice heading to the penalty box on a misconduct. It's a power jam for Sun State.
Yeah, Baby Rocket skates on. She looks a little tired, but I don't think she's going to be told to call it off in a power jam.
Is that beautiful moment of elation and then devastation when you're a tired jammer who's been told you're the only jammer on the track.
And now a forearm call to Baby Rocket will take her off the track. Well, maybe she wanted a rest, but she doesn't want this one. That's not the wrong seat.
Not like this.
Swift Justice stepping back onto the track. Just a minute remaining in the jammer, about halfway through. Swift Justice with power trying to spin around the blockers who are in a four brace for Sun State in turn number three. Now getting some jammer support from her blockers, Swift Justice tries again.
Yeah, very tight defensive formation from Sun State, but Swift Justice is finding, she's so strong, she just pushes through the links in the middle.
And a good power kill there.
Absolutely.
From Sun State as that got Baby Rocket back on the track, and Swift Justice still in that single pass, held up there by Sticks and Bones.
Just constant waterfalling from Sun State, just getting in front of Swift Justice again and again and again. She thinks she has one left, and then all three end up in front.
An end to the jam with no change to score on those final passes. That will be a 14-0 jam for Sun State. Elation on the bench here for the skaters in black, and they've narrowed that gap considerably. Detroit 67, Sun State 55.
So this is Sun State's highest scoring jam so far in this game, and that included a trip to the box by their jammer. We've brought our point differential now within 12 points. As we come in towards the half, and Detroit a little bit slow on the scoreboard here in these last few jams.
Team timeout called by Detroit.
This team timeout is sponsored by RollerGirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience the Canadian dollar. You and I have to experience that every day.
We do.
But some of the people watching at home, it might be your first opportunity to take advantage of our weak currency.
Check it out. You might like it.
Yes.
It is called the Loony.
Yes, it's crazy.
These prices are crazy. Yes.
Crazy. Of course, we'd like to give a shout out to Adam Skates at adamskates.com, Color Falcon Plates, and Color Q4 Boots. Check out all the new colorful goods from Adam Skates.
Are you following us on the internets? Are you commenting on the Twitters? You can reach us by using the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. That's talk, the numeral to WFTDA. There's probably a lively conversation going on there. Lots of armchair coaches across the world.
If you're not on the World Wide Web, you really should be. Questions, comments, tips?
It is Rookert and Chop Chop as we get back to the action. Rocketing across the fast girl start line. They are fast girls, in fact.
Both of them quite fast girls. And a knock to the inside, a risky re-entry is a track cut for Sun State, which means a power jam for Detroit.
Yeah, that was a fast re-entry and a momentary lapse in judgment for Chop Chop as she just decided to rocket away and was not legally able to do so. That leaves Rookert with sole possession of the star and now with lead on this power jam.
Detroit getting a goat in the back of that pack as Jillian Rookert returns. Just a quick slice through that pack for her grand slam.
Now instructed to call off, and that would be a ploy by Detroit to get fresh legs on the track and a power start, I would say.
Absolutely. Sun State Jammer standing in the penalty box, and so Detroit looking to really shut down, take the wind out of their sails, so to speak, with a five-point jam. Trying to cinch another lead jammer status.
It is Wftda Sleaze chosen to do the job. As you mentioned, Peace Slam, Chop Chop standing in the box. Wftda Sleaze tries to grind it around the outside. Gets knocked down there by Slayer Swift. Tries again. And again, Slayer Swift putting the hip into her. It's Dodge and Bolt also getting in on that as Chop Chop returns. No more power start.
Yeah, Detroit splitting up to do offense. It almost looked like they wouldn't have time to hold back. Chop Chop, who goes to the box for another track cut penalty.
Oh, a lonely few minutes for Chop Chop as Wftda Sleaze eligible to score inside the pack. Very little resistance there. Wftda Sleaze moves on with 5 points.
Chop Chop getting some words of advice from her bench coach. It's a lonely place in that penalty box, two jams in a row when you can't return to your bench.
Wftda Sleaze still scoring, being held up there by Dodge and Bolt. Calls that, considers that a job well done. That's another 4 points to Detroit's tally. That will give them a 9-point jam, trying to pull away again from Sun State. Detroit 81, Sun State 55, 8.5 minutes in the period.
The Wftda would like to thank 888, Motoskates, and Rollline.
5 second warning. Chop Chop will once again be the jammer as she will be emerging from the box shortly. Racer McChaser jamming for Detroit. As you mentioned earlier, P-Slam, that massive jammer rotation that Detroit has at their disposal, very helpful, and Racer McChaser quickly gains lead.
She took advantage of a hair's width of space on the outside line there. And taking a jersey whip, trying to do it again.
Star pass, Sun State. Chop Chop passing that off to Trauma Junkie. To no avail as Racer McChaser takes 4 more points and calls it.
Frequent strategy to put out another jammer as pivot when you have those back-to-back jammer penalties and just break the cycle, let that person clear their head. But you were speaking of the deep jammer rotation. Sun State having to adapt to a lot of different jamming styles in this game. But their formations are very strong and very calm and methodical, a lot like you see from Victorian, their neighbors over in Australia.
Chop Chop.
Jambi.
My apologies, it's Jambi, yes, against Rookert. Jambi quickly gaining lead. Sun State very, very good on their lead percentage. Rookert enters the back of the pack. We'll see no steal there from Detroit. A 2-point pickup for Sun State.
Another last-minute call-off there, trying to signal to her jammer ref from the outside line. First points on the board for Sun State in a few jams now. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the 2016 Wftda Tournament MVPs. Visit them at fastgirlskates.com.
Swift Justice on the Fast Girl start line for Detroit. It is Baby Rocket, number 7 for the Swarm. Baby Rocket takes a spill, has to reorient herself.
So much strength here from Swift Justice with a little toe stop spin on the inside of turn one as your lead jammer for Detroit.
Baby Rocket also skating free, chasing the pack. Swift Justice scoring. picks up four, decides that will do, calls it off with instructions from the bench. And that's Detroit continuing to build a tidy lead. Six more minutes remaining in the period. I'm sure Detroit will want to build on that as we head to the half.
Swift Justice with a 75% lead jammer percentage in this bout so far. Just so much power and strength, especially on the middle. Against the lines, we saw a little bit less success, but then that toe sauce spin on the inside took Sun State by surprise.
Trauma Junkie and Feta Sleaze get back into it now. Feta Sleaze up at the front, pushing hard against Janosaurus Rex. With patience, she outweighs the pack. Feta Sleaze is lead. Meanwhile, Trauma Junkie having some difficulty. The pack is swirling around now as Feta Sleaze gets into the center of it. Once again, runs into Janosaurus Rex. A duo of blockers working away there. That's Janosaurus Rex along with Dodge and Bolt. But Feta Sleaze comes around the outside. That is the full five for her.
We're seeing a stash here from Sun State, but the pivot has just rejoined the game after that penalty out of play. And she is so far away from Trauma Junkie.
Sun State slams the jaws of a triangle closed on Feta Sleaze, but she turns that into a duo and then a single, and then with patience, Feta Sleaze is out for five.
Number 180 from Sun State getting a pat on the head from her teammate. Remember, your pivot. You have the stripe.
Trauma Junkie. She was skating free but is unable to contact the pack before the jam is called. A 10-point jam for Detroit that has them flirting with triple-digit territory at 99. The Sun State Swarm 57 and 4 minutes remaining.
I don't know what Detroit discussed in that timeout, but it has really made such a big difference. Sun State virtually scoreless since that last timeout, and Detroit with almost all the lead jammer percentages since. Sorry, lead jammer statuses since.
Jambi, Racer McChaser, jammers of the right now. Into the pack immediately, Racer McChaser trying to barge her way to the front against Coconuts. A trio of blockers trying to shut down Racer McChaser. They force her to place a foot into the infield, so she goes around the outside again. No lead jammer yet declared. Things are really physical in between turns one and two here. We have a no pass, so Jambi has escaped the pack but is not lead.
Racer McChaser finally twirls around the outside, calls off that jam before Jambi can score.
And so much blood, sweat, and tears, and no gain on the scoreboard. Three minutes remaining in the period. Detroit still at 99, Sun State 57. Baby Rocket returning to the Fast Girls start line. She will be joined by Rookert and an official review.
Official review called, I believe, by Sun State. Sorry, by Detroit. Possibly over that no pass, no penalty. Not sure what they hope to gain from it, but seemed to be some disagreement between the referees on turn two, whether that was a track cut or a no pass, no penalty.
Yeah, and if a coach sees any kind of indecision on an official's face, that would be the moment to jump in.
That's their bread and butter right now. Leading the points right now for the Swarm is Baby Rocket with 30 of their 57 points thus far. Feta Sleaze, the lead point scorer for the Detroit Derby Girls with 46 out of their 99, almost half the points so far. Followed by Racer McChaser with 23, and Jillian Rookert and Swift Justice both have 15.
And things fairly penalty light for both teams, although Janosaurus Rex on the Sun City side in a little bit of trouble with five. We are just receiving some confirmation as to the nature of the official review. We will relay that information as it becomes available. Here is Double H.
So they would like a, I believe, a back block call levied against the black jammer. There was a no call that that Detroit believes should be a call, and they are debating it right now.
Interesting choice, perhaps a smart choice by Detroit. We saw a lot of back blocks from the Sun State jammers in the beginning of this game. And if that is still sort of lurking in the ref's heads, especially the coach's head.
if you have the opportunity to ask for something truly tangible, like boxing an enemy skater, that would be something you could ask for, especially with just a couple of minutes remaining in the period. Now is the time to burn off that OR.
You could ask someone who likes you a whole lot for a championship VIP pass. The 2016 International WFTDA Championship tickets are on sale now. Get your VIP tickets to Champs for only $125. And there's limited tickets remaining that include a reserve seating in the best seats of the house, a 2016 Championship Collectors Program, and a VIP badge and lanyard. That's going down in Portland, Oregon.
Head referee, Law and Order, delivering the decision. Okay. Double H.
All right. So they wanted either a back block, a low block, or a late hit call for the black jammer at the end of that last jam. And guys, they got it. That means Sun State is going to start with a jammer in the box.
So for all you bench coaches watching at home, be flexible. Give them a list of penalties they can choose from. Don't try and pigeonhole the ref.
That was a broad spectrum request, and it paid off.
Listen, I'm not fussy as long as she starts in the box.
And so, Rookard, flying solo on the jammer line, gains lead. Just about 2.5 minutes remaining. Jill Rookard, now on a scoring pass. Oh, with ease, just a little sweep there from Detroit to get her the room she needed to come through for the full five.
Yeah, they spread out their offense there, and Sun State didn't really know where to react. Left Jillian Rooker just a whisper of space on the inside. Speaking of which, Jambi from Sun State using about that much room to get her initial pass in.
Yeah, and Rooker waiting until the last possible second, killing time there before Jambi hits the pack, calls it off. So 2 minutes remain. That was a 10-point jam for Detroit. They're now at 109, Sun State remaining at 57.
We're heading into what might be the last jam of this first half. And what a back and forth between these two teams.
Yeah, Sun State consistently able to gain lead, but Detroit pulling away on the scoreboard, putting up the numbers. Swift Justice pushing away inside the pack. Trauma Junkie held to the inside line, but quickly springs free. And Trauma Junkie with a nice maneuver there to get herself into that lead jammer position.
Yeah, speaking of which, Sun State only 2 points in the last eight jams. So Trauma Junkie having an opportunity to change that scoreboard a little bit as we head into the half, try and end on a high note. Swift Justice is going nowhere fast.
That's five for Trauma Junkie. She's certainly done her bit for the scoreboard. Now, trying to squeeze backwards through a wall like you'd negotiate a hedge.
The game is won and lost by those hips, so even if you can't get your feet through, you can still pick up 3 points, it looks like, by just squeezing those hips in first.
Yeah, Trauma Junkie with three more. 8 points on the jam. That will bring Sun State to 65, but Detroit passing ahead of them with a score of 109. Just about 30 seconds remaining. We'll squeeze in one more jam. Fetta Sleaze and Baby Rocket, jammers of the now. Fetta Sleaze, ever a fan of just charging straight up the center. But Baby Rocket slightly ahead, but Fetta Sleaze is going to force this call off as she's overtaken Baby Rocket, and that will run us out of time. Oh, maybe not.
Official review called by Sun State, so we're going to have a bit of a delay going into the change rooms right now.
No sense taking that official review back to the change room. They don't get it back.
You can't take it with you. So with 3 seconds left on the period clock, we might end up with a bit of a mix-up here. So looking at the stats right now, Baby Rocket with a 67% lead jammer percentage over Detroit has Swift Justice with 60. But Detroit just able to make better use of chasing those jammers, of using those power jams.
Yeah, and SunState is able to gain a few points at the back end by stealing some points due to late call-offs, mm-hmm. but it hasn't really made a huge difference on the scoreboard. And, yeah, official review simply used as a timeout there to allow us to squeeze in the bonus jam.
All right, SunState not wanting to waste any time.
And so Jambi and Racer McChaser will represent their teams. One blocker in the box for Detroit. One blocker's room, which will allow Jambi to pull into lead.
Great strategy here is Racer McChaser taken to the line. SunState really locking down the defense in the front.
Racer McChaser still held. One to beat in turn two. Racer McChaser now finished her initial. Jambi decides to grab a few points. It happens to be four, and then she calls it off. And that will bring us into halftime. SunState 69, Detroit 109. Interesting stuff, Pink Slaminate.
Yeah, I mean, looking at these penalties, it really tells the story with these power jams. Looks like the Swarm giving up seven in that first half.
Yeah, seven to jammers.
Yeah. Not a great versus Swift Justice with only one trip to the box in this half for all of the Detroit jammers. And again, with that depth of jammer rotation, the SunState blockers have a really tight formation. They've got a good system going, but it's hard to adapt to that many jammers and that many strong jammers.
Well, yeah, and Detroit hasn't really dipped into that jammer pool yet. Both teams using a four-team rotation, but Detroit could easily go with jammer number 5, 6, and 7 should they require it. Yes. Although it doesn't seem like they're going to have to with no penalties to three of those four jammers going into the second half.
All right, well, we will meet you right back here in just a few minutes at the WFTDA Division I playoffs in Montreal. I'm Pink Slimonade. This is Lightning Slim. Grab a snack and then bring your butt right back here.
Welcome back, folks. You are watching WFTDA.tv, the 2016 International WFTDA Division I playoffs live from Montreal. My name is Lightning Slim. I'm joined by Pink Slimonade, and you're watching Detroit take on SunState, the Swarm. How are we doing?
So in your 8 versus 9 seed game, our score at halftime right now, 109 in favor of the Detroit All-Stars over 69 for the SunState Swarm. The Swarm with favoring a triad formation, a very tight formation, a very sort of trusting, slow formation, and Detroit really winning the one-on-one game. A lot of strength, a lot of power. Their offense, it looks scattered, but it creates so much chaos when their jammers come through that SunState doesn't know where to reform, doesn't know who to get in front of. And SunState not having problem getting lead jammer at all, but having problem hanging on to that lead
right,
jammer.
Right, yeah. They very often get lead and then they'll receive a penalty and lose that lead. And it's looking at the score for the individual jammers, it's sort of a story of not who is scoring, but who is being scored upon, because three out of the four Swarm jammers have a negative differential in the game. Only Baby Rocket with 67% lead, she's up 26 for the 30 points she scored.
Yeah, Baby Rocket, the lead scorer for SunState in sanctioned WFTDA gameplay in 2016 with a differential of positive 26 points. We see a lot of risks taken by the SunState jammers, a lot of good footwork, a lot of taking the lines. Sometimes it works out for them, but a lot of the time it doesn't. And we've seen in those, you know, that late hit that sent the SunState jammer to the box, or the back blocks that they were dealing with early on in the game. The risky kind of track cut penalties that, you know, unnecessary penalties that just sort of come with this fast-paced, sort of frantic gameplay. We've seen the defense lock it down, but can the jammers sort of calm it down?
That's right, because it seems to be the opposite way with Detroit, because SunState, 7 jammer penalties in the first half, yeah. And Detroit with only a single penalty across 4 jammers.
Yeah, their jammers playing it a little bit safer, their defense more so going for the sort of shock and awe style.
We'll see after the locker room pep talk if SunState can adjust their strategy, adapt to this hard-hitting Detroit team that is determined to break up any sort of formation they put up, and what kind of a second half it will be.
Yeah, they definitely ended on a high note with a 0 jam with lead percentage and then 5 points going into halftime. So perhaps they can continue that momentum into the second half.
Skaters now returning to the track. It'll be Jill Rookert jamming for Detroit. Detroit wearing the red. Sun State in the black with yellow accent. Jambi will take the star for them.
Jambi, of course, with two trips to the box so far in this game. 16 this year in sanctioned gameplay overall.
Jambi cannot penetrate that forward triangle of Detroit. Recycled there. Rookert pushed to the inside. Now, chest to chest with sticks and bones, and Rookert breaks free. Rookert has lead for Detroit.
Jambi being guided to the outside of turn two, cuts to the in, but then leaves the track.
Cutting the track, the penalty here to Rookert. She did a bit of fancy footwork on the inside line coming out of turn number two while she was on a scoring pass, and she must have put one wheel out of bounds. That will be a power jam for Jambi. Jambi cautiously approaching the pack. The pack backing slowly from turn two into the apex. Jambi now applying herself, eligible to score. Find some room on the inside, a bit of toe-stop dancing. She must have been able to clear that as there's no track-cutting penalty. Still standing on her toe-stops and absorbing hits while she's doing it is Jambi.
Yeah, the line seems to be the hill she likes to die on, and she will not get off that line if she thinks there's a chance she remained in bounds.
And she's gotten away with it thus far in this jam, although Rookert now returning from the penalty box, so that has been an effective penalty kill from Detroit to keep Jambi inside that single pass she's been doing. And Rookert goes for it, and a reversal of fortunes as cutting the track, the penalty coming now to Jambi, and a reversal of the power jam.
Jillian Rookert showing a lot of her skating skills here with her speed and her lateral movement, but her apex jump's a little bit halted and a little bit cautious. They're very short and normally ends up putting one foot completely out of bounds.
Rookert now using shoulder strength to try to squeeze through on the inside, unable to do so. Now getting a little bit of jammer support. Fetis Lee's getting in on that, trying to clear some space for Rookert as the jam whistled down. Points on either side. We'll see where that shakes out on the scoreboard.
Your score now 124-73 at the conclusion of that jam. Of course, the WFTDA would like to give a shout out to Quick Bearings. Roll faster, farther, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick. Racer McChaser taking your fast girl starts line unopposed on this power jam start.
Jambi, yes, standing in the penalty area as Racer McChaser solo up against a trio of blockers from Sun State.
Detroit opting to prep their defense rather than assist Racer McChaser at the front. Three blockers push to the end of the engagement zone, but Racer McChaser taken over the line and recycled.
Yes, she's taken all the way back there. Jambi able to escape the penalty box. Racer McChaser did gain lead designation before she was recycled, so she decides to call that before Jambi can engage.
Racer McChaser with 304 points this season in sanctioned gameplay, second only to Sarah Heipel and Jillian Rookert. Your score 124-73. And that is Baby Rocket number 7 for Sun State going up against Swift Justice number 10 for Detroit.
5 second warning. Play begins. Baby Rocket stepping into the center of the pack. Swift Justice moving the entire wall with her. Oh, bodies falling into the infield.
Absolutely punishing hit from number 182 from Sun State. That sticks and bones.
More players being upended in the apex. Baby Rocket, who has been the most successful jammer for Sun State thus far, she gains lead.
Sun State matching the aggression that Detroit showed us in this first half.
Well, that's maybe a realization that they were losing some of those physical battles in the first half. Things slowing down now as we get into a grind, a forearm penalty to a Detroit blocker, and a spin on the inside line by Baby Rocket.
Baby Rocket deciding to finish what Sticks and Bones started at the front of that pack. turning around and bracing her from behind, playing defense.
That is helping out your buds. Baby Rocket now hitting the pack and hands to hips, calls off the jam as Swift Justice comes in there with her. No change to the score on those passes, but...
That's such an interesting choice, you know, with lead jammer status. Maybe she just saw out of the corner of her eye Swift Justice about to get around Sticks and Bones, and that snap judgment of like, hey, no, here, I'll help you. It allows Swift Justice to obviously close some space in between them, but it's just a really interesting move there.
Trauma Junkie, Thetis Lees, Jammers of the Now. Trauma Junkie upended immediately, but hops back up on her skates. And Thetis Lees, the penalty, cutting the track to Thetis Lees. Trauma Junkie, sole possessor of a star, and also she has lead.
First lead jammer status of the half here. Second lead jammer status of the half for Trauma Junkie.
Trauma Junkie moving diagonally through the pack and getting some buffeting as she heads through there, getting some jammer support now, moving around on the outside. Trauma Junkie with a successful scoring pass. It is the full five. She will not be satisfied with that as Fetis Lees is standing in the penalty area, now released from the penalty box. Trauma Junkie has not seen Fetis Lees. Sees her now. They're both in the pack. Trauma Junkie continues to skate. She knows Fetis Lees has only completed initial. Getting some help from Sticks and Bones. Trauma Junkie now calls off the jam with three additional points.
Again with the hip swivel from Trauma Junkie, sticking her hips in and then popping them out. You only need to pass once before calling that jam, picking up her 3 points. Your score, 124 to 86. And Trauma Junkie with a lead percentage this season of about 40%. So far in this contest, 43% lead percentage, so pretty consistent, but a negative 12 score differential.
Chop Chop and Rookert. Rookert with great speed around the outside.
Beautiful fake out from Rookert, making an easy first pass.
Chop Chop now ramming into the blockers, trying to escape the pack and stop some of this scoring rush here from Jill Rooker. Jill Rooker putting up 5 points, but Chop Chop has escaped the pack also, trying to limit the number of passes that Rooker can make. Call it,
Jillian.
Yells the coach of Detroit, Jill Rooker, four additional on the pass.
Jillian Rooker just adopting the strategy in this last jam of just don't slow down. Speed is what I'm good at. Speed is what I'm going to stick to. And Sunstate had no time to react.
Yeah, she seems like she's gained a bit of confidence in terms of spotting where the holes in Sunstate's defense are and maintaining speed as she goes around. Another jam about to begin. Jambi and Racer McChaser, jammers of the moment. Racer McChaser cannot quite squeeze past Sticks and Bones. I'm not sure Sticks and Bones ever leaves the track for Sunstate. She's been out there almost constantly.
An absolute linchpin in their defense. Racer McChaser going up on her toe stops, taking the line, and then pushing back. It looks like, speaking of toe stops, she seems to have lost one or part of hers. She's trailing with her left foot. It's a wheel. It's a truck missing from her skate. And a whole truck. The crowd here is absolutely just giving her all the love they've got. Gets 4 points on 6 wheels.
That's not bad, really.
No, I mean, not too shabby. Whatever.
That's value, I think.
I mean, most people use 8, some people use 6. Not a big deal. Your score, 137 to 86. But all the skaters on the track are still just marveling at what just happened. Swift Justice with a huge smile on her face going up against number 7, Baby Rocket.
Baby Rocket recycled. Swift Justice having some difficulty pushing. She's no slouch at pushing, but it's taking some time. And bodies falling over the apex. Baby Rocket able to escape all of that chaos. She comes out with lead. Swift Justice still patiently pushing away at the defenders in front of her. Baby Rocket now has a trio to contend with in turn number 2. Nice toe stop work from Baby Rocket. Comes out with a scoring pass. Is it a complete scoring pass? No, it is 4. But Swift Justice also skating free. Baby Rocket, yes, gets instructions from the bench, calls that off just before Swift Justice can engage Peaceland.
The Sun State bench looking a little indecisive on whether they wanted her to call that or not. I mean, burning the clock at this point when you're 47 points behind with 20 minutes to go, not a great choice, although Sun State did have a blocker still sitting in the penalty box. Fetisley's taking the Fast Girl State start line for Detroit up against Trauma Junkie from Sun State.
Both jammers. A little room to work as there are blockers in the penalty area, and room to work for Trauma Junkie on the outside. Gains her lead. Fetisley's is sitting in the penalty box, cutting the track, the penalty there. Now, here are the penalties that Detroit didn't take in the first half. Appearing now, Trauma Junkie skating, 5 points on the pass.
A little bit late to the penalty party, and it's definitely helping out Sun State here. Trauma Junkie making her way through on this power jam.
That is the full five for Trauma Junkie. Fetisley's is standing. That penalty almost served, but damage done on the scoreboard by Sun State as Trauma Junkie getting into the thick of things. Fetisley's reapplying herself to the pack. Fetisley's did not complete an initial pass, so she still has to do the work, and Trauma Junkie has time to score, although now having some difficulty with the defense of Detroit. Getting some sweep assistance here on the inside line is Trauma Junkie, but still surrounded by red uniforms. Takes a hit there from Freakin' Reakin. Calling it now is Trauma Junkie. The jam is over.
So it's hard to say if Detroit is losing their way on the jammer penalties, maybe getting a little too confident, or it could be a case of a very strict jammer referee. Of course, they switch up at halftime, and it seems to be right in line with a sort of change in fates for Detroit. Who can really say?
But it's 18 and a half minutes remaining in the contest. Chop Chop and Rookert, jammers of the moment. Chop Chop not afraid to fall to her knees while pushing against the wall because very quickly popping up again. But Rookert with breakaway speed, zipping through the pack, picks up lead quickly. Chop Chop will put pressure on Rookert as she is in the free area of the track as well. Rookert bursting through a duo of blockers. Now taken out of bounds. Chop Chop knocked down in the center of the pack. Rookert makes a recovery, comes through with 4 points. Chop Chop recycled again, not able to make any headway through the pack, knocked to the interior. Direction of gameplay coming to the blocker who did that, but Rookert skates on with a grand slam. Chop Chop now through the pack. That is 4 points, four hard 1 points. She took a lot of physical punishment inside the pack doing that, and Rookert half calls off the jam, almost got the whistles blowing, but thought better of it.
A little teaser from Rookert, maybe not going to pay off
A little apex jump from Rookert. Chop Chop matching the score there, 4 each on the pass. Rookert wonders about making contact with Chop Chop, but elects to call off the jam instead.
The WFTDA would like to give a shout out to Adam Skates. Adam Skates, hashtag color me Adam, or visit them at adamskates.com. Your score now, 155 to 113. Sun State sort of inching a little closer. We went 18 to 8 in that last jam, so that running long points sort of working out for Detroit, but underestimating Chop Chop for sure in that last pass.
The winner of this game going on to face the London Roller Girls, the number one seed, at 6 o'clock tonight. Lead jammer for Sun State. Jambi. Room to work here. As Cookie Rumble, taking her first turn on the jammer line, is still firmly ensconced within the pack. Jambi on a scoring pass. Moves through for the full five. Penalty coming there to the pivot of Detroit.
Cookie Rumble taking the inside line. Finally getting out of the pack. Of course, Racer and Chase are still dealing with her equipment malfunction.
Yeah, that would be a straight substitution for Racer McChaser. She's had to get an entire truck put back on that skate.
She's in the shop right now. Luckily, we've got tons of our sponsors on site, such as Powerdyne. Powerdyne's changed the game again with a newly redesigned Arius Platinum. Arius Platinum, performance redefined.
SunState going 8-0 on that jam. Closing the gap a little bit. Detroit 155, SunState 121, 15.5 minutes remaining. Feta Sleaze doing what she can for Detroit as Jambi begins in the box. And so a power start here for Feta Sleaze. And she's giving instructions to her blockers. Her blockers swarming around, trying to break up that defensive posture of SunState. Feta Sleaze squeezing, trying to get between the two blockers at the front of the pack with patience. Feta Sleaze comes out. It is the full five as Jambi returns to the track.
SunState with a really swift and really focused recycle, but not putting enough strength behind that hold. When they get Feta Sleaze behind them, she just pushes forward
Jambi,
with all that strength.
Jambi nudged to the inside and recycled. Feta Sleaze comes through for 4 points on the pass. And just as quickly as she got out of the penalty box, the pivot of Detroit, number 241, she heads right back in there, lollipops them hard. And Feta Sleaze with an additional three as the jam is called off.
The conclusion of that jam, 12 points on the board for Detroit, putting them at 167 to 121. We're about halfway through the second half of game two. Of course, Wftda would like to give a shout out to Bruised Skate Noose, Double Threat Skates, and Fast Girl Skates.
On the Fast Girl start line, Baby Rocket and Jill Rookard.
Baby Rocket adding to her 67% lead percentage so far in this bout, even with a pack disadvantage, just screams out of that pack. Jillian Rookard chasing her down.
Baby Rocket bouncing around a blocker and quickly calling it off before Rookard can arrive. A quick four and the door for Baby Rocket.
Baby Rocket just dominating so far in this game for the Swarm. 43 points. Trauma Junkie close with 39 points for SunState, but the difference being Baby Rocket with a plus minus of 39 versus Trauma Junkie, who often gets scored upon. Her plus minus is only 3. Cookie Rumble back at it for the Detroit Derby girls, up against number 224, Trauma Junkie.
Trauma Junkie tries to make a leap into the center of the pack. She succeeded, and she is lead.
Two blockers in the box for SunState, and they still manage, one blocker in the box, they still manage a very quick lead jammer status and an even quicker scoring pass.
Yeah, Trauma Junkie has a full track on Cookie Rumble, and looking from the other side, manages to call it off before Cookie Rumble's arrival.
4-0 jam in favor of SunState. Your score, 167 to 129. S1 helmets, they have the S1 Pro knee pad. Stability, function, durability, and superior shock absorption make the S1 Pro knee pad built for roller derby. See it at s1helmets.com.
This is the second game of the tournament. This morning, Rocky Mountain winning over Kallio's Rolling Rainbow, 155 to 151, a 4-point victory and a real heartbreaker for the Finns.
Absolutely. That was such a nail-biter of a game. Of course, this team timeout brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience Canadian customer service.
And that is a timeout for SunState.
This morning we saw another game that, you know, really could have gone either way with two teams that were sort of a question mark in this tournament and 4 points separating them in that last jam. Just an absolute nail biter, Rocky Mountain coming out on top.
You can pick up a copy of Derby Nerd's new book, Eight Wheeled Freedom, online or at any good bookstore. That is Eight Wheeled Freedom by our good friend D.D. Miller, the Derby Nerd.
We've got it right here on our announcer table. It has a cover. It has a back cover. It has several pages inside it. They're numbered.
It is a book.
It's it's a real live book.
Timeout coming to a close. About 12 and a half, 12:24, where the clock is frozen.
Jillian Rookard taking your Fast Girl Skate start line with 67 points so far in this context, up against Jambi, who has scored 31 points.
Wow, what a maneuver by Jambi to get out of the pack. Rookard upended.
Again, that aggression sort of blossoming out of Sun State, and a track cut penalty going to Jillian Rooker is going to mean a power jam for Brisbane, Australia.
Jambi skating on. She's the full five in that pass, just as Rooker's posterior hits the penalty bench. Calmly assessing the pack, Jambi giving some instructions to her blockers. They do a bit of an outside sweep. Now Jambi inside the pack, but the defenses of Detroit reforming in front of her. Detroit have very often been purveyors of a quickly reforming wall. They do so in that case. Jambi stops it after four.
Yeah, Sun State just sort of trying to inject themselves into that Detroit formation and do whatever they could. And Jambi, while not technically escaping the pack, got her hips around all four and picked up all four of her points, 9-0 in that last game. Your score, 167 to 138. This time, Baby Rocket taking your fast girl skate start line while Jillian Rooker sits it out in the box. One hand out, but still in play.
Yeah, Baby Rocket has been a lead jam generation machine. But however, no one saw Rooker coming back from the penalty area. The pack had not moved from the start box, so Rooker was able to just step right out of the box and into that lead position.
Rooker taken to the outside of turn one and just a quick juke to the in.
And a quick scoring pass. Rooker grabs four, calls it.
It's an interesting use of the clock here as Sun State sort of sluggish on the call-offs, not necessarily burning time, but definitely not saving it either, versus Detroit, really quick call-offs here. Even though they are in the lead, they may be looking at this from a ranking standpoint at this point. They feel comfortable with 10 minutes left at 171 to 138, and now they just want to see how many points they can put up in that time.
Trauma Junkie, Racer McChaser, jammers of the right now. Trauma Junkie getting into the center of things. She has had some great spin maneuvers today. There's another sprawling on the track.
Low block going to number 180 from Sun State. That's SX.
Racer McChaser skating free. That will mean Trauma Junkie will have to work quickly to score. Quickly calls it off before Racer McChaser can arrive. That is three on the board for Sun State.
The Sun State Jammers using really efficient use of those passes, though. Swiveling the hips in. They know it's their last pass. They're not so much worried about getting through. It's just getting those points.
Well, as you pointed out earlier, Pink Slam, all you have to do is put the hips in to the center of the blocker formation. You can even you can come back out again.
You put your both hips in. You take both hips out. And then you don't need to put them back in again. You can just shake it all about.
You shake it all about,
just
yes.
Shake it.
Jambi, Swift Justice. Jambi very quickly jumping into lead position, but Swift Justice in pursuit.
Swift Justice with 38% lead jammer status for Detroit, tied with Jillian Rooker, versus Jambi with a 40% lead jammer status.
And a quick end to the jam with 2 points on the board for Jambi and the Swarm. Detroit All-Stars, a score of 171, Sun State 143.
Wftda would like to shout out to RollerCon, Spank Alley, and Chaya. So in the last six jams, Detroit only managed to put up 4 points. So some of that steam definitely disappearing. And as we say, that Baby Rocket getting lead jammer status for Sun State.
Feta Sleaze, one to beat at the front of the pack. It's Janosaurus Rex, who's skating on 5 penalties and has, well, now it's 6.
And now it is 6.
Fetis Lees, however, escaping as a result of that penalty. A 4-point scoring pass there for Baby Rocket. She says that will do. And you're absolutely right, Pink Slaminade. They're not super fast on the call-offs on the Sun State side.
No, and I'm not sure if that hesitation is coming from just a tradition of always looking to the bench, not making those judgments yourself, or just some confusion on what their aim is right here.
They're not really making blunders. It's just very casual for a game in which they are behind.
Yeah, in the waitressing industry, they used to call it a sense of urgency, and we're not seeing it from these call-offs from Sun State. Of course, we have a timeout right now, which are brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience the Canadian dollar.
That timeout will be charged to Detroit. Some discussion there, maybe how to hammer the lid shut on Sun State, who have sort of, you know, refused to go away, hanging there with Detroit the entire time. Things have not gone Detroit's way penalty-wise in the second period as
Sun State really kind of blossoming under the pressure. It's just sort of a real slapdash start from the Swarm with the penalty trouble, you know, scoring early and then just sort of sitting scoreless for several jams in that first half. And now you're seeing the aggression come out. You're seeing sort of smarter risks being taken, more footwork in the middle of the pack and less just running for the lines. In the last seven jams, they've scored 26 points over Detroit's 4. And if they keep up this trajectory with 7.5 minutes left, they could take this.
They could indeed. And what a prize would await them to face a very hungry, very focused London Roller Girls, the first seed.
That's the big one. Jillian Rookard facing off against Trauma Junkie on your Fast Girl Skate start line.
Trauma Junkie getting into the back of the pack, but Rookard is long gone with lead.
Detroit once again rejuvenated by the timeout. I'm not sure what their pep talk is, but every time they come back from a timeout, they come back absolutely swinging.
A trio of blockers trying to push Rookard out in turn number one. She manages to keep her skates in. That is 5 points for Rookard of Detroit. She's having a much better second half, very focused. Star pass for Sun State. Trauma Junkie passing off the star there, but Rookard calls off the jam, and Dodge and Bolt will not have a chance to score.
Seeing more of these skate skills from Jillian Rookard, she spun on one skate and actually leaned against the blocker for balance to stay in bounds, hip to hip, completely legal. And on that last jump, she just went up on one foot, just lifted that inside knee up. Instead of trying to go for these sort of long, shallow jumps across the track, she just kind of missed her knee, went right up into the air there.
And so if this score maintains, we'll see an upset of the ninth seed over the eighth.
Beautiful assist here from Sticks and Bones.
Yeah, she sprung Jambi quite easily. Jambi into that lead position. She is facing off against Racer McChaser. Racer McChaser pushing against a set of four blockers, now bleeding into a three in turn number one. Jambi trying to split the defense of Detroit on a scoring pass. Jambi in turn number two now gets some speed going. Jambi coming out with the full five. Racer McChaser stealthing around one of her blockers, finds room to work around the outside, knocking down some resistance. Racer McChaser now free, but Jambi inside the pack scoring again. The pack between turns one and two called off there with three additional points for Sun State.
A really nice power coming in the back of that pack from Jambi. She didn't look to be really gearing up for that hot hit, but she was able to just pinball off of those back hips and get 3 points for her trouble. 180 to 155 with just 5.5 minutes left in this game. We have ourselves a 25-point differential. The only points scored for Detroit in these last nine jams were by Jillian Rookard. Right now we have Wftda Sleaze on the line, who has a 33% lead jammer percentage versus Baby Rocket, who's sitting at 67.
Wftda Sleaze pushing against three in turn number one. Still just making it out of the start box is Baby Rocket. Wftda Sleaze does gain lead, but Baby Rocket is there with her. The team's now deciding if they want to do some speed control as Wftda Sleaze chases the pack. Sun State is trying to get away from Wftda Sleaze. She inverts to get the hips past one, but does not succeed. No score on the jam.
Wftda Sleaze really breaking away from Baby Rocket there and being able to pick up the speed despite Detroit being in the back of that pack. The Wftda would like to give a shout out to S1 Cone Law Offices and of course rollergirl.ca.
Only 4 minutes remaining in the contest. Detroit still in the lead. Jambi and Rookard on the Fast Girls start line.
Jambi, now your lead point scorer so far in this game for the Swarm. Really having an incredible second half. Lead jammer going to the Swarm.
Yeah, Jambi takes a look, but Rookard with great speed catching up to Jambi, who has to call off quickly. And tidy work there by Jambi to get a 4-0 jam in for Sun State. They're creeping up on the lead of Detroit.
Yeah, Sun State not leaving Detroit a lot of time to react. And we've got an official timeout. Looks like an official review? Nope, simply an official timeout here from the referee crew. So we've got time to look at a quick rundown of these stats. Racer McChaser leading with lead percentages for Detroit, 50% lead percentage versus Baby Rocket has 67 for the Swarm. But again, with this penalty story, the jammer box trips in this last half, looks like we've got 23 so far in this game for Sun State. Detroit with 21. So Detroit catching up on the penalty game. It's a late start. It's early in the morning here. In the last 11 jams, Sun State has gone 38-13.
We are ready to begin again. It is Racer McChaser. Skate repaired. Back on the track. And a penalty to Baby Rocket wearing the star for Sun State. And forearm, the call there, meaning that Racer McChaser, power jam for Detroit, a chance here to really blow open this lead for the skaters in red. She has five to begin with.
Racer McChaser back in the driver's seat with this new truck might be the momentum shift that Detroit needs.
Yeah, five more on the board for Racer McChaser. Very calmly sizing up the situation. Racer McChaser back into the pack. Pushing at the front. Her blockers leave her to her own devices. Sun State is bridging to try and keep that defensive posture in front of Racer McChaser. Baby Rocket has returned from the penalty area, but she cannot penetrate the defense at the back of the pack. From Detroit, both jammers exerting a lot and going nowhere.
Everyone sort of playing it a little bit safe right now. The jammers losing their steam, losing their energy towards the end of this game, not wanting to get taken out on the line.
Yeah, bleeding a blocker to the box, direction of gameplay going to SX. That will burst free Racer McChaser. She's able to get out. That is five more points on the pass for her. Racer McChaser inside the pack, looking for more. Baby Rocket stumbles across the top of the apex, does not incur a penalty. She must have landed. Looked painful, though.
In any case, it hurt. 15 points for Racer McChaser in that last pass. Now widens the point spread, 195-159 with a minute and a half left.
Yeah, 15 points hurts more than a spill.
An official timeout called by Sun State. FastGirlSkates.com. FastGirl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making a faster you.
Coming up next here at the Division I playoffs in Montreal, we will have the 6-3 seeded game. 6-seed Boston will take on Bay Area at 2 o'clock Eastern Time.
And this timeout, of course, brought to you by RollerGirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience Canadian customer service.
What do you, citizens of Planet Roller Derby, think of the action thus far here in Montreal? You can reach out to us on Twitter using the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. That is TalkToWFTDA. What do you think of the time management which has been displayed by the coaching staff from these teams, the great talent that you've seen on the track?
What would you do if you had to skate on six wheels?
Yes. I would die. I would just curl up into a ball.
That's an excerpt from my nightmare right there. Of course, if you'd like to see your product being featured on this broadcast, sponsorship is still available for future WFTDA.tv broadcasts. Contact sponsorship at WFTDA.com.
Clock frozen at 127. Sun State 159, Detroit 195. That was a 15-point jam by Detroit we're coming off of. They've been widening their lead, trying to hammer the lid shut on Sun State.
Yes, Sun State only in a minute and a half to make up 36 points. It's not inconceivable. Janosaurus Rex from the Swarm, it looks like she has fouled out of the game. as well as SX. So two foul outs from the Swarm.
And looking at the Detroit side, no one in any real danger.
No. Lolly pops him hard with four trips to the box. But with, you know, a minute and a half left in the game, she's in no trouble.
So the Swarm experiencing a bit of a breakdown in discipline as they've been behind on the scoreboard. They've had to take more and more chances, and that has resulted in more penalties. I believe we have some clarification as to the nature of the penalty. Here is Double H.
So Baby Rocket coming out of the end of that jam, very frustrated, looking for a call that was not made. She wanted a low block call because she actually tripped her way through the apex guys, but no call was made. They lose the review.
She did indeed take a tumble, but no change to gameplay as the officials did not deem that she should get a penalty called in her favor.
Normally a low block happens when your trip through the pack is impeded by some point. When you complete an apex jump and get in front of everybody, normally you say thank you. You say thank you, gravity. Thank you, physics. You don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Not a gift apex jump, that's for sure.
A two-point pickup there for Sun State on the jam. That brings them to 161, Detroit 195. Just about 45 seconds left in official gameplay.
Jillian Rookard with 16 jams so far in this game and one more lead jammer status for Detroit.
Rookard now chasing the pack, things moving. Rookard simply has to pass the two blockers which remain on the track. Yes, Rookard gets through the pack. There's a four-point pass for her, for Jillian Rookard.
And a timeout called by Sun State.
Yeah,
Sun State. 16 seconds left on the period clock.
Yeah, they'll want to extend this. They'll want to try and get another jam in and try and close the gap on the score. All of this for ranking points, of course.
Yeah, Jillian Rookard really finding her footing in this game. Of course, all timeouts brought to you by rollergirl.ca, Canada's skate shop. Experience Canadian customer service.
That previous jam, a four-point pickup for Detroit. That will bring them to a score of 199. Sun State, 161. The winner goes on to face London today. They will play a second game at 6 o'clock this evening.
This is their warm-up for playing the third-ranked team in the world. No big deal.
I'm sure they will be pumped. Okay. Timeout drawn to a close. This will be the concluding jam of the contest. Sun State will have to put up some serious numbers to catch Detroit.
So this has been a bit of an upset here. We have the eighth seed. It's going to be seeding to the ninth seed.
Not if Jambi has anything to say about it. She is lead for Sun State, pushing hard. Racer McChaser. I can't imagine she would have been able to do a good deal of adjustment to her skate as it was repaired, so she's winging it. And that is a penalty to Racer McChaser, cutting the track, power jam to Jambi of the Swarm. Could we see things change here on the scoreboard in this final jam? Jambi, with some great lateral movement, gets through the pack. She has about a minute 20 to work with.
Jambi, the lead point scorer for Sun State, whose fans are on their feet here, making so much noise.
Jambi through the pack one more time. 15-point jam for Sun State. Now at 176, she will have to complete another couple of passes to make this possible. And Racer McChaser is returning from the penalty area. Jambi held up between turns one and two.
Sun State digging into that triangle formation in the front, slowing Racer McChaser, but Jambi not making a lot of progress.
Jambi now moves up to the center of the pack, but she has been recycled. Gets a bit of support here. Sticks and Bones comes back to support Jambi. Gets her into the pack. Jambi now completes another pass, but cuts the track. Jambi will end this in the box. Racer McChaser now on the power jam, just about 15 seconds to play.
Jamie looking absolutely gassed, hoping to call it off. Her bench says, keep going, and the ref says, actually stop right there.
Racer McChaser with the opportunity to complete a pass, but mobbed by the blockers of Sun State. What else can they do at this point? And time expires. More points on the board for Detroit. Your unofficial score, Detroit 204, Sun State 180. We will await any numerical corrections, but this is solidly a victory for the ninth seed, Detroit, over seed number eight, Sun State.
It looked like Sun State was going to be able to come back and cinch that win, but thank goodness for whoever fixed Racer McChaser's skate, because it looks like that sort of changed the tide. Not that Detroit doesn't enjoy, sort of get spoiled by a lot of strong jammers, but when you lose one of your main rotation, it's a big difference here.
But when Racer McChaser returned from having her skate repaired, things really started going for Detroit again. So her contribution to the cause, not to be underestimated. And yes, big ups to that skate tech.
Yeah, she had the highest lead percentage for Detroit with 54%. The leading scorer, Jillian Rooker, with 84 and a point differential of plus 48. Meanwhile, over on Sun State, Baby Rocket with 47 points. Jambi coming ahead and finishing as the top scorer with 73 points. Jambi really finding her footing in the second half. She was here, she was in Dallas last year at playoffs at Sun State's first appearance for the WFTDA. And I'd like to see what they're able to pull out against their next opponent. Who's that going to be, Lightning Slim?
Sun State. Detroit's next opponent will be London. Sun State will play tomorrow at 10 o'clock against the loser of the game coming up, which is Bay Area and Boston. Boston, the number six seed, Bay Area seed number three. So we'll have to wait to see the outcome of that game, and they will play Sun State tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern Time.
All right. Well, if you have been watching today on WFTDA, you know that we've had two very close games so far, so we don't really know what to expect out of this next game. Bay Area Boston, while it is seed three, seed six, we haven't been able to take anything for granted so far. It has been a really exciting playoff season, so make sure you have your butts back here. Trackside right now, we have AK 40 outs with Kelly Janai from the Detroit Derby All-Stars. My name is Pink Slamonade.
I'm Lightning Slim. Here's AK.
Thank you, up in the booth. I am here with Kelly Janai, one of the captains of the Detroit Derby Girls All-Stars. Victorious this morning, 204 to 180. And this is the first primary bracket win you guys have had since 2013. You've worked your way from D2 back up into here. And how does it feel to get that out of the way?
It just feels really good. We were trying to get a win this morning, so we really hope to be able to play London again. You know, we played them a lot. They're good friends of ours. We love it. So that's really what we were looking forward to. We really just wanted to play London tonight and get a win here, no matter how close the game was, so we could do it again.
All right, so speaking of London, for those of you who don't know, 0-3 recently against London, two trips over to Europe. The first time you went, the two losses sent you down into Division II, but of course Detroit ended up victorious, taking gold in D2 2 years ago. And then earlier this season, another loss to them. You're familiar with this team. What is your mindset going into this game, especially with everything else piled on top of it, it being playoffs and all?
For us, it's really just about staying on the track. We know that if we can keep a cleaner game, which has always been a challenge for us, if we can skate cleaner and stay on the track, then we can execute our strategy, which, you know, we can't do short blockers and short players. So that's all it is. It's just staying on the track and doing better than we've done against them previously, and that's the only goal.
And another question, because Twitter is alive, and thank you out there watching, listening, hashtag talk to WFTDA. Everybody wants to know, it's a team effort, of course, and you play with who you got, but Sarah Heupel, the new addition, back to Detroit this year. Where was she today?
Sarah wasn't able to make the trip with us. We're short her, but luckily we have a really deep bench of jammers, and you know, all of the information that she's brought is still part of the team, and you know, is really exciting and has helped us a lot. So she's still a part of us on the track, whether she's here with us or not. So.
All right. Well, thank you very much. Congratulations again, and we'll see you tonight versus London. Stay tuned on WFTDA.tv for more.